Out dry runs, installed state-of-the-art automation equipment, set up a top-tier engineering and operations team, and have made great progress toward building a better battery right here in San Jose. Now, let's take a closer look at our new Raptor separator production process, our AI-enabled inspection capabilities, and introduce our first B samples.
One of the processes we've talked a lot about over the last year is Raptor, the first deployment of our next-generation fast separator production process. Raptor comprises several different tools that work together to produce our separator films. Material is loaded into the Raptor heat treatment equipment. This equipment supports a continuous flow process to maximize throughput and energy efficiency. This process is essential to obtain the high-quality solid ceramic separator that enables fast lithium transport while also providing the barrier between anode and cathode that we believe improves safety. Raptor is faster than our last generation process, cutting the amount of energy needed to produce each separator and increasing the equipment's throughput. Raptor also removes several process steps entirely, eliminating material inputs and reducing cost. The separators we make using the Raptor process are being used to produce our first low-volume B samples of QSE 5.
Technology can do. Second, we are building a global ecosystem of partners around our technology platform. Every breakthrough technology relies on a teamwork to change the world, whether it is smartphones or artificial intelligence. Technology revolutions can only happen when companies around the world see the opportunity and work together to make it a reality.
To make battery-grade materials, we need to eliminate defects and non-uniformities. And doing so requires an understanding of which non-uniformities matter and which don't. From years of research on our ceramic solid electrolyte separator and our other battery components, we've developed a deep understanding of this aspect of ceramic manufacturing. Here at QuantumScape, we use various inspection methods, including optical imaging. We like imaging because it's fast and non-destructive. But engineers eventually need numbers to make statistical decisions. So we've developed a set of image analysis algorithms that turn images into numbers that describe part quality. The images are fed into our machine learning models to identify defects on each battery component that might correlate with cell performance. In our Raptor line, in fact, we've integrated 12 different machine learning models into the workflow and these models turn our raw inspection data into actionable metrics. We use this AI-based approach every day to select high-quality Raptor films to be built into cells. And on top of that, engineers across the organization regularly use the outputs of these machine learning models as a fast, direct way to measure the success of their experiments. Over time, we continue to improve our metrology hardware systems and our software models, and this ability to rapidly iterate is powerful at any scale. We've incorporated computer vision and machine learning models into inspection points throughout our production processes, and each of these checkpoints is an opportunity to monitor process stability, to accelerate our process development learning cycles, and most importantly, this ensures the quality of our battery prototypes.
We need to build a global network of equipment vendors, material suppliers, contract manufacturers, auto OEMs, and others. Every member of this ecosystem has an important role to play. Supply chain partners can scale a production of critical materials to the levels necessary to satisfy global demand.
And work we've put in, these very first samples from the B sample phase will provide invaluable learnings for the team as we continue to focus on improving quality and reliability.
As a technology company, we have always been very data intensive. So ability to parse, analyze, and draw conclusions from data is extraordinarily important to us. With a copious amount of data we produce, AI naturally gives us a new set of tools to get technology to market much faster. That's where the biggest use of AI for us is. You know, people talk in terms of societal risks. It is for companies that use in social networks for them to think about. For us in the technology space, it is not quite as important as a risk in that sense. For us, the strength of the model is based on the strength of the data. The data we produce produces the model. We draw inferences from there, picture data to digital data, etc. We are not so worried about societal risks of AI from a QuantumScape perspective. As more advanced AI models develop, the biggest is going to be in terms of turning technology into product very fast. How do I detect defects? How do I detect manufacturing processes fast? How do I reduce variability? How do I control a process? All those kinds of industrial applications, AI is going to make a great help in getting time to market faster.